Item price already in the car. There is the black bin liners covering the front tyres. The tyres have been scrubbed clean, getting any bits of stone and straw and dust and muck away from the surface of those front tyres. No tyre warmers allowed in hill climbing. They have been not allowed for well over 30 years, I'd say. And therefore, the only way you can put any heat into the tyres is by spinning the rears as they come to the line. He does three bursts of tyre warming. He's already sitting on the line, slightly yellow tint to the visor, wriggling around in the cockpit, and he's ready to go. He leaves the line, and he does the first 64 feet in 2.07 seconds. This is a rapid car. And lifted off very, very slightly at the kennel, at crossing. Now he's back on the gas. We go through there, flat, yes, flat, and into the S approach now. And the line on it. Out of the top part of the S's, back end just steps out slightly under the box, accelerating now at the finishing line.
25.75 seconds is the first time in the runoff here at Shelsley. 25.75, 114 miles an hour as he crossed the finish line, 126 miles an hour as he was on S approach. So that car will come straight back down the hill, and Sean Gould will get in it very quickly indeed. Sean Gould will get in it because he will then be the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth runner out of the 12 that we've got in this runoff. Quickest run so far today, Wallace Menges, 23.78 seconds. 23.78 seconds that Menges did in the Goulds. Actually, the car, the very same chassis that holds the outright record here at Shelsley, with Martin Groves, 22.58 seconds. Simply amazing time that was set by Groves, multiple British champion, and may well be here today. I haven't seen him. He might be here today. I saw three-time British champion Martin Bolsover here yesterday. The 1989 British champion Ray Rowan here today as he was yesterday.
We've seen Chris Kramer as well up there somewhere.
Okay, good. And let us not forget the champions who are still driving. Oh, Roger Moran, let us not forget, 97. He's here today. And the champions who are currently driving in the shape of Trevor Willis, Alex Summers and Scott Moran. Okay, so Price has returned now down to the bottom of the hill, and it's going to be Eddie Hollier who comes to the line in this Empire Evo, all the best bits on it for the different chassis that Bill Chaplin's Empire Racing Cars Concern make. And Eddie, always a quick driver, always rapidly off the line and up any hill, wherever he is around the UK. Formerly a sort of a southern specialist, the Gerstons, the Whiskams, and then he had that little OMS sports car as he travelled a little bit further afield, and now he's in a single-seater, and Eddie Hollier is eighth in the championship at the moment. Sits on the line, another all-red car, visor goes down, and Eddie Hollier's revs rise. Here we go, building, concentrating. Now he lets the clutch in. Second gear, third gear, 2.15 seconds.
Lovely line through the kennel bend. He qualified under 25.73. Arno Price was 0.3 of a second quicker than his qualifications. See what Eddie Hollier can do. Keeps it tucked up on the left-hand side under my box here. Accelerating beautifully. Lovely, lovely line through the S-complex there and over the finishing line.
And he's quicker than Price. 25.49. 25.49. 114 miles an hour as he crossed the finish line. 131 on S approach. The commitment through the bottom of the hill, through kennel, through crossing. You need to keep your momentum. You need to keep the speed because Shelsley really is steeper than you think. Next up, we've got Richard Spedding. Richard Spedding with the GWR Raptor, another 1600cc car. Spedding fourth at the moment in this year's British Hill Climb Championship. A few more rounds still to go, including the one that we are in. We've still got Shelsley here today, Gersten, Prescott, Doon and Lowton Park. So spinning a little bit further over from his right-hand side of the racetrack. Tiny little car. Car similar. Oh, they're trying to stop him. Stop him. People waving behind him. Maybe they've seen something that Richard is unaware of. And I think it's to do with a wheel. So they just saw something as it was being warmed up. And they were concerned about the rear wheel nuts, which is a great concern. A lot of the wheel nuts, single wheel nuts to the centre of these racing wheels, then some of them being held in by a safety clip. But if those clips have maybe been forgotten or something, then better to be safe than sorry, as Steve Marr comes up with a wrench and just double checks the rear left. That looks to be up to spec and up to torque. He now goes over to the rear right. Are you going to check that rear right? No, it seems to be okay, does it? Steve Marr at the rear of the car as Richard Spenning sits in it and wonders what needs to be done. Well, the battery's being plugged in and the car will be restarted. And Richard's got to compose himself, needs to keep his rhythm, keep his thought process and be ready for the run. Can't get it into gear, maybe he needs to shunt the car to get it into gear, shaking his head. He can't get it into gear, the marshal is trying to roll the car forward to get it into gear, now he's maybe asking to get the car in a different position. Okay, he's ready, he's off, it's simple as that, he's on his way, 2.17 seconds, can he keep his concentration? I'm sure he can.
Almost flat through the Camelband, Richard Spenning, here he is at crossing, again he's just kept the gas on, he went up a gear, he's flat through the kink, he's into the exit, 110. He has to back out on it slightly, out of the top part of the S's now, middle of the road and over the line.
25.35, quickest. Didn't ruffle him, did it? 25.35, 118 miles an hour over the line, 110 on S approach. So 25.35 makes him quickest at the moment from Eddie Hollier, from Einan Price. That's your 1-2-3 at the moment, as we have Jason Morant come to the line in the 4-litre to Judd engine, I believe, Eddie.
Yes, Judd EV.
So an engine that used to be with Leighton House old engine. Yes, with Leighton House, with Formula One at the end of the 80s, early 90s. Bored out, and now a 4-litre. He leaves the line, puff of smoke. Big car, big traction control, big acceleration.
So Jason, he had a big shunt at Lowton Park in June, but he's actually gone even quicker since then and scored more points. He's into the S's now. He did back off early.
Unflustered line through the S complex there, a little bit slower than the other guys. He's over the line now.
25.22. It's quicker. 141 miles an hour over the line. He'll be very happy with that. That's some 0.4 of a second quicker than his qualifying time, as Morant now goes to the top of the table with 25.22 from Spenning, from Hollier, from Price.
But the slowest to the S's split,
yeah, and slowest through the S's as well.
There's plenty of grunt there.
Well, yeah, but he's doing 30, but he's doing 23 mile an hour quicker over the line than Spenning.
Yeah, there we
he's
are.
He's got a 4-litre, not a 1600. And Shelsley will always be a power hill. The only way to get round it, if you've got a smaller engine, is to have added lightness. As we have now Graham Wynn on the line, car number 188 in the Gould. Sits on the line, the blue and yellow stripe going down the nose of the car. Perfect conditions here at the base of the hill. Blue sky over our heads, a leafy team valley in the background, but the modern technology of a Gould is already into Kennel. 2.17 seconds for the first 64.
So the championship co-sponsor with us already, stepping on it. No sparks from the underside of this car. And 128 in front.
The bottom part of the S's, but does just clip the drain cover. Nicely middle of the road though, swiftly through the S-Complex, one of the quickest over the line.
25.27, second position for him by just 0.05 of a second, 134 miles an hour over the line. We were talking about former British champions here at Shelsley today. Chris Wardle, 1988 British champion, is here. Good afternoon to you, sir. Hope that you're enjoying Shelsley once more, just as you did a month ago. So then, we've now got Sean Gould coming to the line. We saw this car with Ian Price do a time of 25.75. Sean did a 25.5 in the class runs earlier here this morning. And that means that the focus of Sean, son of David, who constructed that first Gould that won the championship with Chris Kramer back in 1985, the focus of Sean on this run is to go quicker again. He's got to beat a 25.22 to go top of the pile at the moment. This is a car that has supreme aerodynamic downforce and grip through kennel and crossing. 2 seconds exactly for the first 64.
Sharp as you like, through the kennel bend. Look at this, through crossing, absolutely flat. Up the gear. Doesn't lift until now. Into the S's, looking for a pitch.
The S's just misses the concrete. Oh, he has to back out a little bit. It was getting out of control. Had to do a bit of opposite lock, but he's controlled it nicely and he's over the line.
Quicker again, 25.12. He goes quicker than Jason Morant by exactly 1/10 of a second. So Sean Gould is fastest, 114 miles an hour over the line for the little, can I say that, 1600, 117 on S approach, 114 over the line, as we now have Gould quickest from Morant, from Spedding, from Eddie Hollier, fourth, Price and Wynn. Trevor Willis now sits on the line. Trevor Willis, former best time of day man here at Shelsley, former British champion from a couple of years ago, lives only over the hill from Abberley at Far Forest, and is ultra, ultra quick in this OMS. He leaves the line, first 64 in 1.97.
Here's Trevor Willis now, and didn't qualify with the sort of time he would have wanted. Oh, look at the sparks from underneath the car, he's into the S's. Now,
left-hand side of the track, now into the middle and over the line.
Should be quickest, and it is! 23.86! 23.86 seconds, not best time of the day, but quickest in this all-important runoff for the points here at Shelsley. So it's Willis first, from Gould second, from Morant third at the moment. David Uren now coming to the line in the turbocharged Force 1300cc, did a 24.34 to qualify for this runoff. Sits very low in the car, doesn't he? But this is a very, very rapid car indeed. What did he do? 140 on S approach earlier, 1.99, first 64 feet.
And wangs it a little bit out of the camel bend. He's almost with David already, absolutely stepping on it.
Yes, he really is turning. Slightly holds onto it beautifully, bounces it over the drain cover, shower of sparks over the line.
23.8 to beat, 24.07. He goes second at the moment to Trevor Willis. So David does a 24.07 and 135 miles an hour when he crossed the line. So it's Uren from Willis, from Gould, from Morant, Spedding, Hollier, Price and Wynn. Next up we have got Alex Summers, British champion in the HillClimb Championship from last year, shared with Scott Moran 12 months ago. He's on his own this weekend. He's sharing the Coley car. The V6 leaves the line in 2.2.
Well, let's see if this car's ever been quicker in the hands of the Coley brothers. British champion absolutely motoring. Turns into the S's 100.
Just steps slightly, holds on to it beautifully. Tried to step out on him in the top part of the S's. Caught it again over the line.
2.406, a hundredth quicker than David Uren, and he's second quickest. The little V6 might just be running out of puff here against the bigger capacity V8s, but there's certainly no lack of effort and commitment there from Summers. 7.44 seconds through the S's. Mind-blowing.
mind-blowing. Will Hall now on the line. So we've got three to go. Will Hall, Scott Moran, and Wallace Menges. Great hill climbing this is. Will Hall on the line with the four-cylinder turbocharged engine behind him in the force. Ian Dayson stands behind. Everybody in the paddock watches. Will Hall, leave the line. And he does the first 64 feet in 2.01.
Will Hall flies into the kennel bend. He ran very wide. Through crossing already. Centre of the track. Big bang from the exhaust. And he's into the engine now. It's Will turns into the engine. It comes up to it nicely. Very flat through the S. It's accelerating.
Over the finishing line now.
23.97. 23.97. He goes second to Trevor Willis at the moment with two to go. 23.97, 138 miles an hour when he crossed the finish line. Two to go. Scott Moran and Wallace Menges. A real battle of titans here in the Team Valley. Paddock is absolutely full. Absolutely full. Everybody in the dual drive paddock looking, maybe standing a little bit further back to have a view of the car as it leaves the line and rockets away into kennel. I remind you, for those of you watching up the hill, when the car comes into view from behind the trees before the first corner, these cars are already doing 100 miles an hour. 100 miles an hour. The S approach speed that Eddie gives you, some 130, maybe 140 miles an hour before they're braking for the S's. They're coming out of top S at maybe 46, 47 miles an hour and putting on another 100 by the time they get to the line. Scott Moran, on the line, black and white gold, five-time British champion, current championship leader, sure to leave here, still leading the championship. He has a 21-point lead and he's on his way. First 64 in 2 seconds exactly.
Five times champ through Kemmel already. The proper line at the crossing. No trailing of sparks until he reaches the members' enclosure.
It'll drift out to the left under the box here and over the line now.
And he's quickest. 23.54. 23.54. So that means that if Wallace Menges is to win this runoff, he's got to do the fastest run here at Shelsley today. 23.54 seconds for Scott Moran. He did 141 miles an hour over the line. And that is a gauntlet thrown down to Wallace Menges as to who is going to win this runoff, and a gauntlet to many others from Scott Moran as to who is going to win this year's British Hill Climb Championship. Scott Moran, by the way, quicker through the S's by 100th of a second than Alex Summers in a car that probably just a little bit heavier as well. So then, Wallace Menges is on the line in the Ferrari red gold, checks everything is all in position, visor goes down, the red gloves hold the wheel, he's on his way already. First 64 feet, brilliant, 1.96.
Out of the kennel, at the crossing already, barely time to breathe, he'll be with David, now 136.
Yeah, well, it turns into the air. Clips the concrete gently, also clips the drain cover, unusually accelerating now though, up the finishing straight and over the line.
23.54 to beat, 23.06, he's won the runoff! Wallace Menges, what a run! He hasn't won the runoff, he's annihilated the competition, annihilated them by nearly a clear half a second here at Shelsley. 136 on S approach, 143 miles an hour as he crossed the line. That's great hill climbing, ladies and gentlemen. That's a great runoff. It must have been super spectacular to watch in the middle box, Eddie.
It was fantastic, yes. That was as good a run as I've ever seen Wallace do. And of course, he's got a bit of a record of taking runoff victories here. So it looks like the lunch break.
Yes, a great runoff that we've had here. So Wallace Menges wins the round of the runoff of the championship here today. We've got another one later with a 23.06 from Scott Moran second, from Trevor Willis in third, Will Hall in fourth, Alex Summers gets fifth position from David Oren in sixth, Sean Gould seventh, Jason Moran in eighth, Richard Spedding, Eddie Hollier, Aidan Price and Graham Wynn round out the top 12 here. What a great runoff. And the quickest run that we have seen here at Shelsley was the last run that you've just seen here. Quickest off the first 60, for the first 64 feet. Quickest to kennel. Quickest to crossing. S approach speed, 136. Quickest to S split, which is the bottom S. Quickest through the S's, and then that's where you get half a second by the time that Wallace Menges has got to the top of the hill. 23.06 seconds. Half a second to go. That's the absolute track record, isn't it, gentlemen? Trouble is, that's the difficult half a second, isn't it?
Just slightly.
Yes, as if they weren't hanging it out enough.